Then it comes to merchants. Hmm. The way merchant approach things. When you go in Singapore, merchants are very well aware of technological changes they are happening, having. They have such high cost, they are ready to adapt to any technology that helps them reduce the cost. When you're coming in Thailand, the overheads are significantly lower.
Yes.
And the merchant's attitude towards this technology is very different. Then when e-commerce was booming or technology sector was booming, as I had earlier pointed out, they had a negative experience, which plays on their mind.
Right.
They are scared whether they will get their money back. So these all play into the way they adapt technology or on the guarantees of delivery that they expect. When you go in India, the payment morale is very, very low. People believe, I would not say it's low, but point is the industry or Indian economy is set up in a manner where they expect huge credits.
Right.
So today they are getting credits of 3 to 6 months on each and every of their supply, and they expect that technology would also be the same.
And I'm sure that impacts your current account as well, because you would be being from India, I can only say that your money coming from the merchants would be much slower than if you compare it with,
absolutely,
let's say, Hong Kong or...
Absolutely. Our working capital requirement of India is the highest.
Hmm.
Right? Just because we understand that the payment cycles are slower.
Yes.
So definitely, cultural challenges is one of the big challenges. As a company, there is no right way. We have a model of Gojek, where they are trying to adapt to each country and localizing their brand. And then you have Uber, which is global and a very uniform experience. So it depends on how you want to structure the company, how you want to structure the brand. As a technology startup, you have to take the call earlier on. If you want to go with a very common brand across region, then you have to plan for it. You have to do focus groups. You have to understand the cultural needs. You have to understand the browsing habits. You have to understand the business needs and adapt your model initially to suit that. I can give you a classic story. When we started Eatigo, the first day 4 founders were there and we were like, come on, guys, what's there not to like? Right, there is a 50% discount, users don't have to pay anything. I mean, we'll put this thing live and suddenly the reservations will start raining. We put on the reservations, the website live, 4 of us are sitting in meeting room for 1 week, 0 reservations. And we were wondering, what the hell happened here, right? Suddenly, there are no reservations. And then we immediately called a focus group. The users came in. And if you see our original website that we had designed, it had a very Agoda kind of a feel, where you come in, you had a home page with a search bar. You could type the restaurant name, restaurant would come. And then suddenly, when we were doing the focus group in Thailand, people said, I don't know what to do, right? I want to see the restaurant.
Right.
I want to know what you're offering, where is the location, then I can decide. So that's when we suddenly realized, oh, this model does not work in Thailand. So that is why you have to be very reactive. You have to understand the need of the customers and give them a product that they want, not a product that you want.
Understood. In fact, it's a commendable job from there to 1 million reservations on a monthly basis.